Well, my name is Danielle Gerhardt, and I work at California State Parks Columbia, and we are in Diggins 1852 Tent Town. So we are recreating the year 1852, an early gold mining encampment. So today you'll see about 150 docents, volunteers, and park staff all dressed in period attire, doing things such as cooking, theater, entertainment, gambling, bakery, laundry, and more.
Driver often stops to yell, get out all hands and push uphill.
A bird?
No, yeah, you're a bird.
I'm a bird.
My name is Seamus, and I'm digging a hole, digging up dirt with the shifters, and looking for gold.
What shall we do with a drunken sailor? Lie in the morning, waiting up she rises, waiting up she rises, waiting up she rises. Lie in the morning, put him in a longboat till he's sober, put him in a longboat till he's sober.
Yes, my name is Philip. I'm running the chain pump here. So what this is doing is this pumping water uphill to this machine. So the miners could use this to pump water out of their coyote hole or their section of river they were mining. Here we're using it to bring water from that long tom, reuse the water. So as I spin this, these paddles catch the water below, bring it up through the box, dump the water into this long tom. So we can use it to separate the dirt to find the gold.
Put them in the bilge and make them drink it early in the morning. Wayin' up she rises, wayin' up she rises, wayin' up she rises, early in the morning. Shave his belly with a rusty razor, shave his belly with a rusty razor, shave his belly with a rusty razor, early in the morning.
This is one of my young chickens. She's 12 and a half weeks old. This is Mary Ann. She's a Dominique. When she grows up, she'll lay me an egg a day, and I can sell it for up to $3 an egg to a hungry miner.
Keel haul him until he's sober, keel haul him until he's sober, keel haul him until he's sober, early in the morning.
Captain Timothy Sutherland off the Whalen brig, Star of Nantucket in San Francisco. And today we're here at the Star Spangled Banner Saloon doing the Wheel of Fortune. Have folks get an opportunity to win a free shot of sarsaparilla. Ma'am, if you'll just put your number down there. Oh, here's a tip for you.
My lucky number.
Your lucky number is number 28. Okay, and we'll spin around here. I'm just holding this so it won't fall out. You understand? Perfectly fair game. Honest, this day is long. And we have number 13. I'm sorry, ma'am. Not a winner today, but come back and try again tomorrow. If you step inside and see some pepperoni.
My name is David Swearens, and I came out here to Gold Country for gold, but I'm an entertainer from the old states. I play the banjo and the theater troupe here, and this is one of the biggest towns west of San Francisco until you get to Salt Lake or St. Joe. There's culture, there's theaters, the fine establishments. It's a great place to live.
They camped on the flat, 'twas nearby the road on a
my name's Michelle. We're working the bakery today. So we're selling lemonade and biscuits, fruit turnovers and scones, and some bread and sugar biscuits outside.
Hello, good sir. Welcome to the Union Restaurant at our Diggins 1852. My workers here, Miss Molly and Miss Vasquez, are preparing our hash. We have potatoes and onions we're cooking up for your lovely dinner today. For supper, we have hash cooking. We also have wondrous cornbread and beans as well. So we would love to serve you.
Fire. My name is Joel Acker and I am getting my fire hot, so I'm going to start to do some blacksmithing. So today I'm going to make a fireplace poker.
Yes, I'm Richard Zadina, and we're here today at the Columbia Diggins, and today we're working on just a classic miner stew. Miners tended to make stews during lunch. It was a really common meal because throw a lot of stuff in a pot, let it boil, let it cook, keep going back to work. So that was a really, really simple standard lunch. Beans, potatoes, salt pork would be thrown in there quite often. That was a common meat entity here, so that was easily shippable across the nation. And fresh beef. We had a lot of cow around here, a lot of cattle. So those are a few common ingredients in some stews.
Thank you.
Phrenology is the study of the human mind. And what a phrenologist does is to measure your head in the 33 different localities and then give you a detailed chart, an explanation of what those numbers mean. The purpose in life is to make yourself happy. And you'd be surprised how many people don't know how to become happy. So we tell you what things interest you and make you happy.
Calliope Dodge.
Have you and the doctor been married long?
Well, I don't think we've discussed it.
I know speak it is.
Ich spreche Deutsch.
Dutch?
Deutsch.
Dutch?
German. Dutch.
Dutch. I don't speak no Dutch.
I barely speak English.
The fingers.
Nine.
Fingers. That's what you got. You got a fingers? I know you got it. I got a fingers. Lots of fingers. Right here.
Dupe.
See?
Dupe is for this. Dupe is for this.
I don't understand it.
Cuckoo.
Cuckoo?
You cuckoo.
Cuckoo.
Yeah.
Isn't that a kind of a bird?
No, yeah, you're a bird. Bird
I'm
bird.
A bird. A bird?
Bird brain.
Bird brain.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's an insult or not. I know some pretty smart birds. They talk better English than you do.
Ich kann nicht Englisch sprechen. Ich meine Deutsch, Mann.
Well, I can't help it if you got that problem.
Ich komme hier gestern, yesterday.
Yeah.
I just been a new boy on block.
New kid on the block.
No, not kid, boy.
Is this new kid on the block?
No, boy.
Boy?
Boy on block.
Yeah. You don't look like an old boy.
I do not look like a kid because a kid is a goat.
Oh, that's
you
it.
Call me a goat?
You calling me a goat?
Yeah, you call me a kid.
Oh, that's what that is.
You call me a kid and a kid is a goat.
A kid is a goat?
Yes.
Well, I raised goats back home. I didn't like it because they're so stinky. Thank you.
washing clothes. This is how we wash our clothes. Everything is done by hand. We're going to put some soap on it, and then we're going to scrub it on the board, turn it over, scrub it some more till it's clean. Then we're going to rinse it, and then we squeeze it out, and then we're going to hang it on the line with some clothespins, and then it'll be ironed. We're going to do this whole pan and get everything nice and clean. It might take us 2 days to get it all cleaned and pressed, and then a few days later, we're going to have to do it all over again.
Hurdy-gurdy. Now, that's what the English call it. Couldn't tell you what it really means. But I got this instrument right here from a Frenchie down in Valparaiso when we come across from Boston. You know, all them ships stop in at Valparaiso pretty much to pick up water and fruit and all and such. But I prayed of a Colt's patent pistol for this. He said this had been in his family's possession for a couple hundreds of years, I guess. But he didn't call it a hurdy-gurdy. He spoke French, now you see, and he called it in his language, and I hope I get this right, but he says it was a vielle en roue, meaning a violin with wheels.
My name is Joseph Centennial Clary. I was the first Justice of the Peace here in Columbia. I got my first judgeship in late 1850. I was the JP in 1851. I lost it to the voters. And it was again in 1853, I believe. At least that's the story. And I only do misdemeanor cases and civil cases. If it's a criminal offense, it has to go to the county judge in Sonora, California.
McFarland, and I'm making English-style bobbin lace today. This is something that was a cottage industry in England in the late 1800s. But here in California, there weren't a lot of women, and so there wasn't a lot of lace being made. But it's something I enjoy doing very much, and I'm making lace for my niece's wedding veil.
So would you like two of my spills?
Yes.
I can't charge you a whole eagle for those, but I'll be happy to just give you two.
Standing here today on the side of God and man to join together this lovely couple in matrimony. To be together not only for next week, but at least for a couple weeks after that. And if everything goes right, for the rest of their lives. So Ronald, you take this lovely lady to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold, to care for her, to feed her, to give her a place to live, and a donkey to ride, not only now, but for the rest of her life.
Yes, sir, I do.
And Victoria, do you take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband, to cook, to clean up after, to to wash, dry, and fold for now, but forever.
I do.
You must be crazy, girl. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. By the power vested in me, by 1852, City of Columbia, County of Tuolumne, it's a state of confusion. I now present to you man and wife, Ronald and Victoria. Let's give them a big hand.
Star Straw, and I'm going to play Shenandoah.
Thank you, Star.
Are you ready?
Yep.
What's your name?